Within these bushes, Oromo Liberation Army fighters are carrying out their morning parade. They have no headquarters or base and move constantly in the direction of the federal forces. Since the start of the war, the OLA has fought many battles with the army. It now occupies territory located only a few hours' drive from Addis Ababa. Today, these soldiers are training for combat.
Then our army is ready to crash this military of Ethiopian regime. We have a program to do that from day to day, from week to week. In a month, we have a plan to do the practice, and also we do something on the field rather than practice always.
The men enlisted by the OLA are not professional fighters. Some were students, others were working. They took up arms and received formal military training to go up against government forces.
We in the OLA, our goal is to liberate our people and our land. We're not afraid of death. We're not afraid to stand up to our enemies. If necessary, we will break our own bones into pieces to build the bridges that will lead our people to freedom. The government soldiers don't know why they fight, so they're afraid. But we're determined, and that's why we're winning.
The OLA claims many victories. In this video, which the rebels say they filmed on September 15th, they take control of a town west of Addis Ababa. According to them, residents of the town welcome their win, and many internally displaced people come to ask for their protection. Other civilians opted to leave and took refuge further south, on the other side of the border in Kenya. 100 families live in this makeshift camp. They left everything when the army invaded their village. They explained that the military killed one of their own and were planning to execute some men in the village.
They told us this boy wasn't going to be the only one killed, that they had a list of 17 men who were going to be executed. So we were very scared. We immediately decided to flee to Kenya. That was on April 15th.
No access to water or a doctor. Living conditions here are harsh, and village elders are unable to say when it will be possible to return to Ethiopia.
At the moment, there is fighting between Oromo and Amhara forces who are collaborating with the government. Recently, I heard on radio that 20 Oromo were killed. Their houses were burned. The situation is still terrible, and killings are still being carried out. About this war, I can't do anything about it, and I don't think we can expect much from it. It's not going to change our lives.
While he remains doubtful, OLA soldiers say they're fighting for civilians. They want to help the people they consider oppressed by Prime Minister Abiy Ahmed's government.
They steal our property. They rape women, even pregnant women who end up losing their babies. Parents and their children are killed in front of each other. I am fighting with the OLA to free the Oromo people and stop the violation of our rights. I have given up on my comfort, left my home, and I am ready to die to liberate my people.
Off to the side, the group's leaders discuss their next plan of action. The second-in-command predicts that the rebels will topple the government soon.
We want to bring down this murderous regime, along with other people whose rights are being violated, like the Tigrayans and other tribes in Ethiopia. We will unite and form a transitional government that will take care of all the people who have been oppressed.
The rebel groups are unable to say when they plan to attack Addis Ababa, but they are less than 200 kilometers from the capital. To suppress them, the Prime Minister declared that he's leading troops to the front line. In the meantime, the rebels say that they're confident that soon they will take power.